Welcome to the Core Inn, Salt Spring Island's drop-in youth center in downtown Ganges. Costly repairs due to a fire nearly derailed the Core Inn Youth Project. But recently, the Salt Spring Community Services Society stepped forward to administer and provide a stable source of funding.
So it's another eventful summer day. Yeah. Today is kind of busy. We've got lots of kids coming in. During the summer, we're open Monday through Wednesday from 1 to 7 p.m. and then Thursdays and Fridays from 1 to 9. And generally, we just have a drop-in. Kids can play pool, hang out on the computers, foosball. On Friday nights, we're going to be doing a movie night. And Thursday nights, there's a games night. Around the time that I was a teenager, four kids were in a car accident, and there'd been some other accidents around that time. And in that car that got in the accident, two of the kids died and two were very badly injured. And some parents and concerned community members came together and decided that there needed to be a place for youth to hang out, that was sort of a safe place where they could drop in and sort of, you know, not a judgmental place, a place that they could call their own. So this building was actually being, I believe, foreclosed on, and we did a lot of fundraising, and then an anonymous philanthropist donated half the money, and we were able to purchase this building. Salt Spring Island Community Services is in charge of staffing this place and, you know, and the building itself. They plan to maintain it as a youth center. It's going to just be the same, but probably better. They've got access to more resources and there are more staff. And also as a benefit, Salt Spring Community Services had applied for some summer money for summer students. So we've got Dejan here, and he's here for the summer, and also Yoni. And they're going to be doing some programming and working in the drop-in. So we've been able to be open more hours and offer more to the kids.
It's their place. They come in, they have their own playlists on the computers. If they're going to the lake, they'll be meeting here, and you know, it's sort of their home away from home. It's sort of a job where you don't know what to expect every single day, because you could be just working in the kitchen all day and making a lot of food, or you could be talking to somebody about something that's really important in their life. They could be having a really tough day, so you sort of have a counselor's job. Some of the kids that come here are really looking just for somebody to listen to them, and the problems can range from everything from problems at home, domestic, other kids that might be bullying them, or even drug problems with the older kids. And if they come in, it's like a place where people are actually looking at them like real people instead of on the other end of a desk or something like that, because they can come in, order a milkshake or something like that, and just talk to you like you're a real person. That's the tougher end of it, but it's a place where they can come, and if they can unload those problems, you sort of get the sense that maybe they'll be safer out there. Or maybe if you can sort of make a positive influence. And we always have safe sex pamphlets here, stuff on drugs, stuff on cigarettes, stuff like that. I think that's a big part of the Core Inn, making sure that the kids that come in here are safe when they go back out there into the real world.
The kids come first at the Core Inn. Drop in and check it out. From Salt Spring Island, I'm Peter Prince.